Hello everyone, welcome to Home Cooking with me, Hema Subramanian. Now we all enjoy different variety rices and today I'm going to show you this very popular Vangi Bath which is made with brinjals. And I'm also going to show you the Vangi Bath masala powder. We're going to make this from scratch. So let's get started and check out the recipe. First I'm going to make the Vangi Bath masala powder. For this I'm going to dry roast a few ingredients. Take a pan, add 2 tablespoons of chana dal. 1 tablespoon urud dal. First, I'm going to roast the dals just for about 2 minutes. Add 2 tablespoons of coriander seeds, 1 teaspoon cumin seeds, 1 teaspoon whole peppercorns, a small piece of cinnamon, 4 cloves, and 2 cardamom, and 8 red chilies. So, I'm just adding 4 small pieces of tamarind here. Dry roast the ingredients on a medium-low flame for about 5 minutes. Finally, add 2 tablespoons of desiccated coconut. Just toast it nicely. This is dry desiccated coconut. If you don't have this, you can also use fresh coconut. Turn off the stove. Remove the ingredients from the pan. Cool it completely. After the ingredients are completely cooled, transfer to a mixer jar. Add 1/2 teaspoon of hing or aspirata powder, about 1 teaspoon of jaggery, now this is optional, and grind it to a nice fine powder. For this recipe, I've taken 300 grams of fresh brinjals. Cut the brinjals to about medium to small size pieces. You don't want them too large. Make sure you immediately drop them in water so they don't change color. First, I'm going to temper a few ingredients. For this, take a pan, add 1.5 tablespoons of oil. To the pan, add 1 teaspoon of chana dal, 1 teaspoon urud dal, 1/2 teaspoon mustard seeds. Next, add a few peanuts. Add 2 red chilies. Add a pinch of hing or aspirata powder. Next, add a few curry leaves. So once the mustard seeds have splattered and the peanuts have been roasted, add the chopped brinjal pieces. After 2 minutes, add 1/2 teaspoon of turmeric powder, 1 teaspoon salt, next add the Vangi Bath masala powder, I'm adding about 4 teaspoons, they are heaped teaspoons. If I need more masala powder, I will add more a little later. Keep the flame on low. I'm adding 1/2 cup of water to cook the vegetable. Cook the brinjals for about 10 to 15 minutes. The brinjal along with the Vangi Bath masala has come together very nicely. Finally, I'm going to add the cooked rice. So I've cooked about 1 cup of basmati rice, that's a 250 ml cup. So I'm just going to add all of it. Now for this recipe, I'm using basmati rice, that is the long grain rice. But you can use any rice that you normally have at home. Start mixing the brinjals along with the rice. The Vangi Bath has come together so beautifully. Now I'm going to season with a little bit of salt. Check for seasoning. So finally, I'm going to add 1 teaspoon of ghee. Just mix it all in. Delicious Vangi Bath is ready to be served. Make sure you serve it nice and hot. Wow, the Vangi Bath looks fantastic. Now make sure the brinjals are nice and fresh when you make this recipe, and also store the wangi bath masala powder in an airtight jar, and you can refrigerate it and use it whenever you want to make this recipe. This is best enjoyed as is, or you can have it with some nice appalam or vattal, that is wafers or chips by the side. So do try this recipe, enjoy, and share it with your family and friends.